Let's go a little bit more in-depth on burn cards here, because burn cards are allowing people to do absolutely crazy things in Back 4 Blood right now. To very quickly go over what burn cards are in case you missed it, they're a new thing that was added to the December update, and what it does is it allows you to buy cards that are one-use cards during your game. So if you go ahead and you take a look at my decks here, look at burn cards, and I'm going to take a look at my sniper card here, right? So I have 8 of these. So I can use it 8 times, and once I use 8 of these cards, they're gone forever. However, I can resupply that if I go over to the supply lines here and buy one of them, right? So they cost 40 supply points. Supply points are what you get for completing a level. Now, if I were to go back to my decks, what you'll see is I'm going to have 9 of these bad boys. So you can keep replenishing them, and you can have up to 99 of all of them. So that's the basic idea of it. Now, let me show you some of the crazy things people are doing with them. So here we are on 1-1 of Nightmare Mode. Pretty typical landing spot for a lot of different players. I'm going to pick, I don't know, Hoffman. Once more under the breach, I'll pick my boom deck. And we'll go through the very basic sequence of picking your deck, because you need to see the full thing in action so you can really feel its full depth. Now, you get your corruption cards, yada yada, then you get your starter card, pretty cool, and then you get to pick a card, right? So I can pick whatever here. I'll go ahead and I'll pick add and reload. Whoa, I forgot to pick my burn card, don't worry. So I can go ahead and pick my burn card, right? Well, some of these cards have team effects, and one of these is Hell Can Wait, which gives your game an additional continue. Now, all 4 players can play this card at the same time, meaning that you can get 4 extra continues per level. So per resurgence, per pain train, etc. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Now, if I load in, what you'll see is if I press tab, I have 2 continues rather than the default 1. Now, if you're already thinking ahead, you know what I'm about to do here. It goes a little something like this. Okay, goodbye, Mom. Okay, goodbye, Walker. Oh, we got another one here. Aw, poor Carly. Are you gonna die? Oh, no. Now our continues go down from 2 to 1. That's fine, though, because with the December update, there was a huge change to Nightmare Mode. And that huge change is that once you wipe on a continue, you can now pick another card from your deck. So we'll load in here and I can pick another card. Ta-da! Now I have Mag Coupler and I am much stronger now. I don't get to use another burn card because, again, 1 burn card per level. So per resurgence, per pain train, per sound of thunder, whatever level you have. Not per continue, per level. But that doesn't matter, because if 4 people on my team did this, we could go through 4 continues, still have 1 left over on 1-1, and then suddenly, instead of only having 2 cards in 1-1, I have 6. And you can do this every single level. So if you go through 2 levels of doing this, I could have, because you would get an additional card just loading into the level, I would have 11 cards on my 15-card deck by 1-2. By Tunnel of Blood, I would have 11 cards. That's just one of the fun things you can do with burn cards. Let's go into the other ones. So now let's take a look at Hired Gun. Each kill grants 1 copper up to 500 for each Hired Gun card played. So let me show you what that looks like. So take a look at the bottom left of my screen. I started with 3,750 copper. Well, if I kill this guy, ba-bam, now I have 3,751, and then it just keeps going up per thing that I kill. Now, if you go ahead and take a look at Hired Gun here, there's a big detail that it's missing. And that big detail is that it's 500 copper per teammate. So 1 Hired Gun card basically equals one of the bonus cards that you get when you're going through your levels. You can get 2,000 copper for your team from 1 of these. And keep in mind, you can play 4 of these. And then what you'll see here is I come out here and I take something out. Ta-da! I get 1 copper, right? But not only do I get a copper if I kill something, I get a copper if my teammates kill something. So everybody is feeding everybody's economy. And in case you were worried, like, oh god, how do I know if I got 500? 1, you'll just stop seeing the alert. But 2, if you really just want to make it really easy to know how much more you got to hold out for, you just go ahead and press escape and you'll see how many kills each teammate has. Now, bots don't show it, but each teammate will show 14, 15, or 100, 200. So once you reach 500, you'll know that you're maxed out and then you can just go to the next level. And again, if everybody plays one of these, you get 8,000 copper. Chat, it's 1,500 copper for an upgrade. You could get the next, like, almost three levels of both upgrades from one round of hired gun. Never mind all the other money you're picking up, or if you're running money grubbers or anything like that. So you can go ahead and see me come up here and kill this thing, right? One? Well, if we had four people playing the card, instead of that being a one, it'd be a four. Instead of that being a two, it'd be an eight. So instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, it'd be 4, 8, 12, 16. It just balloons like crazy. And something you might have noticed before we even started the level is that you can shoot things from inside the safe room, and that allows you to get extra copper without inflicting any time on the timer that the vendor has. So if you're really, really desperate and you just need, I don't know, 20 more copper, you can sit in here, not open the safe room, and then shoot at stuff. And things will infinitely spawn outside of the safe room. They just keep regenerating themselves. So in theory, you could farm as much as you want out of the safe room. Oh my god, the bots start with purple weapons now? I didn't even realize that. I'm on bad seeds and they have purple weapons. Dude, all they give me over here is green weapons. If you wanted to, you could just run out there, get yourself killed, and then take over a bot, drop their weapons, and then revive yourself and get purple weapons. They only give you green otherwise on bad seeds. What? Are you telling me Hoffman has a purple tack right now? Take me. Oh my god, he does start with a purple tack. What? I could just go be like, bye, and then go have some defibs ready and then steal this thing. Oh my lord. So let's talk about Dusty's Customs weapons here. This allows you to pick pretty much any firearm in the game at any level. What's cool about Dusty's Customs is if I go ahead and I select one here, a couple of things may happen. So if I load on in, what you'll see is I picked an assault rifle and a couple of things happened here. So I was able to farm some pretty decent attachments off of that, right? But one other huge thing is you notice how it's purple. The weapons I start with here on Abandoned are blue. So if you are familiar with when weapons upgrade in color, certain levels signify this is the checkpoint for a color upgrade. So a clean sweep, I think, is when you get blue weapons. I think Hell's Bells is when you can start getting purple. Usually you can tell by the toolkit room. That's a really easy way to know exactly when things are upgradable. So since Hell's Bells was the level before this and I picked Dusty's Customs, I was able to get myself a free purple scar with sick attachments on it. So if you want to use this just to farm attachments, you can do that. But also, if you're trying to upgrade the color of your weapon, it's another good option. And heck, even if I look inside the store here, there was nothing purple. So chances are, I got about one of the best weapons in the game, and I might not see one of those for a long time. Thanks, Dusty. And something else to know about Dusty's Customs is that if you pick the shotgun card, you can get a Belgian. If you pick the SMG card, you can get a Tech 9. It will work on secondaries, but there's nothing for a melee weapon. So you're getting the idea of some of the crazy things you can do with these cards, but allow me to go through some of the other fun ideas here to close out the video. So Windfall, that's just basically a free 600 copper for your whole team. So if everybody plays that, then that's what, 2400 copper? Bam. Extra padding here. Each cleaner gets an extra 20% trauma resistance. And this is general trauma resistance, not just in-cap trauma resistance. So if each player plays that, you get 80% trauma resistance. Not only that, though, if you have a Doc on your team, Doc just comes with 25% team trauma resistance. So with that in mind, suddenly, no more trauma for the rest of the level, which could be really nice if you're playing something like a melee build and you have, what is it called? Battle Lust, is that the one that heals your actual health? This would make it so that's way more effective because you could have your temporary health and then also your regular health. And speaking of other things you can do with your team, let's talk a little bit more in depth about that. So if you're running one of those double AA12 builds that I was doing on stream, by the way, we stream just about every single night, twitch.tv/swingpoint. If you're doing one of those double AA12 builds, you can make it so you have a lot more ammo for your AA12 person if you use ammo drop. Something I'd be curious about here with Slippery When Wet is each cleaner gains the breakout ability, and it reduces its cooldown by 20%. So in my mind, what could be really interesting about this is if you were to have four of these played, that would reduce its cooldown by 80%. Now, if you go ahead and you look at your decks, and then you go and you go to breakout, this decreases the cooldown by 50%. So really, you only need three people to play the card. So in my mind, what that means, especially if you have an Evangelo on your team, Evangelo would basically have infinite stun guns. Because all the other cleaners, when they try to use breakout, they're a little slow at it. I'm not sure if U-Speed affects that. Somebody can let me know in the comments. But Evangelo is really fast at it. So Evangelo, again, would have infinite stun guns if everybody's allowed to play that card. Now, when burn cards were introduced, they did say that some of these have limits. I haven't really seen that yet, but maybe the Slippery When Wet is one of those limits. But Infinite Stun Gun sounds fun in my brain. And if you're worried about Experienced CMT not really healing your trauma as well anymore, well, who cares? You can just use Urgent Care now and heal 60 of your trauma. Because you go all the way down to 40, right? From 100 health. Well, if everybody on your team uses this, suddenly nobody has trauma anymore. So, anyway, this is just some of the fun things I was thinking of with the burn cards. If you guys have any other things that I'm not aware of, please post in the comments down below. If you want to see more of this, we stream just about every single night on twitch.tv/swingpoint. I'd love to see you guys there. Link will be in the description and the top comment. Also, please consider subscribing if these videos have been helpful to you at all. Thank you guys so much. You guys are awesome, and I'll see you in the next video that we do around here.